What is going on, everybody? Boogeyman back again. I know it's been some time. It is what it is, but I've got an exciting video for you guys today. So make sure to stick around, leave a like and subscribe if you enjoy. All right, so without any further hesitation, as you can see right in front of me, I got a fantastic birthday gift. Right here we have a Shure kit. You can see the packaging over here. We got three overhead Shure SM57s and a bass mic as well. 52. This is the kit that it came in. It's very nice case for it with all the mounts and stuff. I actually have it set up over there, but we'll go over that. And then I got the Scarlett 18i 23rd gen Focusrite interface, which is fantastic. So let's go check that out over here. This is kind of my music room, as you can see, kind of like a mini studio. So right off the bat right here, we have the bass drum mic. And I have it kind of slightly in the opening of the porthole. I actually kind of like it slightly in. The thing about this is if you're doing an audio setup, setting up mics for a drum kit, having it in is going to give you more of that reverb kind of... it's definitely not going to be a sharp click, right? Which is what I like. So I hold mine out a little bit just so it's kind of like a sharp pump. So that's what I like. It's honestly up to preference. You can screw around with that all you want. That's what I did. I have kind of a little untraditional setup right here. I have one of the Shure M57s set up right over here and then one right over here. Traditionally, you'll see in some setup videos, there'll be one that's kind of behind you a little bit and then one that's farther towards the left. But there's actually a thing called phase. I'm going out of phase, and I won't get into detail about that. But you just want to make sure that your mic distance for each of these guys, for the overheads, are about the same distance away from the snare. Mine is not because I'm a rookie. But that's only because the song that I was recording with these guys, they just sounded better. The reason I have these guys set up over here is... So they could pick up the toms as well as the hi-hat. That's important. And then I also have the one on the snare right here. And then this guy over here is to pick up the ride because I was playing on the ride and some of the toms and cymbals as well. The two overhead ones right here are turned down significantly just because I don't want them to be overpowering the bass or the snare. But this one is slightly higher, obviously, because I have to catch the hi-hat sound. This is kind of basically a whole setup thing for me here, but right here we have the Scarlett. I did turn it on. A Scarlett 18i20. It takes, I believe, 8 inputs. There's 2 MIDI on the back, and you basically hook these up in the back, and then as you know, you fuck around with the knobs and determine what levels are right for you. There's no exact science for this, mainly. Just dick around, screw around, and kind of figure it out. As far as the software goes, Scarlett 18i20 uses what's called Focusrite Control. So this is a third generation interface right here. Focusrite Control to install the drivers on your computer. I had a huge problem because this is actually not my computer. It's my dad's computer. And it's an older Mac. Mine is a much newer Mac. And because it actually works with the Apple M1 chip, they actually have not created a compatibility with that computer yet. For some reason, so I sent them an email about that, so hopefully we could resolve that issue. But for the meantime, I am recording with my dad's laptop and using both Focusrite Control and GarageBand, which surprisingly works beautifully. And I can actually make a separate video about that if you guys would like. But basically, you just have your set tracks, you got your snare, you got your two overheads, and you got your bass, and you are set to go. Those are all your inputs. And it works like a charm with this computer. So basically, that is the whole setup. I have a music stand over here. We have an Octopad, which I might screw around with, plugging the MIDI into the Scarlett over there. I will be providing a demo at the end of the song. So without further ado, here you are.
This is Animal Neon Trees.